about the importance of the skills and implementation of the skills on real-time basis, real-time basis.
Tools comes later, I would say.
Okay, all the control charts, bar charts, so that we make decisions. I mean, it will help in quicker decision making, it's working on so, did you, apart from the practical example of bugs for bug break? So,
have I used it? That's what you are saying?
Not both them have I used it. What kind of decisions have you taken based on that? And can we go a little bit better? Okay, so you found out that my trend is that it is slowly going up every day and then it's coming down at the end of the project or whatever. So what? I mean, so that is something which will tell you what.
In my previous organization, for 8 months, I was doing run charts and control charts from bias analysis. Believe me, that was my job. I never did any scheduling because that was a conscious job. Whether deliveries are happening on schedule or not, that's delivery manager's job. But being an accountant and head technology of AI and product, every day is early morning, 8 o'clock, I used to be in office till 10 o'clock. Morning to evening, my only schedule was just see whether the variances are in place or not. Plot a graph on variances, put it in control chart and see whether where they are moving. The moment you find so many points going in the consecutive line, identify them. Here is a problem. Boss, go to that team. What's going on, man? So this is the delivery. So what happened yesterday? Go for those 7 days delivery and find out where is the problem, why they are going straight line. I need not to know the schedule of that each and every team member or whatever is going to be involved. Okay, because I am handling almost 21 projects at that time. So these graphs, pictorial representation will be very first, you know, dig into the problem. Here is the problem that I need. Now, what is the problem? That I need to find out which is more on my managerial skill. With my past experience, it comes in picture. But if I start, you know, interacting with those 20 plus projects team every day, half of the time with just one interaction. That's probably answered how I use this.
Yeah, so my advantage you are trying to say is that your data at source or analysis at source will happen, which will improve your decision making. Instead of analysis running somewhere and then the data is passed on. Because these days you have got fantastic tools. I mean, you just log a data and you get fantastic definitions of how your projects are running and who is doing the data, logging the data and from which area the data is coming from. So I mean, I'm still failing to understand how a manager will actually do the same thing. How a manager will actually do the same thing on a piece of paper and get a better analysis. I mean, one thing I understand, yeah, maybe the communication part will increase. Does it on its own, you might have a better insight and take quicker decisions. That is one thing which might be coming out. If that is the more you try to say. Apart from that, anything else that you
can it's not only communication part. When I was handling this team, 20 plus projects, team size was almost 250 plus. So communication was almost impossible. And that difference is always there. The programmer will say, our account head never comes and discusses with us. Okay. Then the second part, he will say, he never understands what is the requirement. Managers always say that, first he thinks the whole world. He will come for a minute and he will say something and go away. And actually it happens. Actually it happens. Now to overcome this problem, being ahead of those learning programs, I would say, that program, okay. What is important for us is, one, achieving the target in terms of delivery. So the VOC, the person to whom you are delivering, meets that quality standard. Voice of customer is achieved. Apart from that, cost, schedule, these are two important factors, time and cost. Now, if you say that, say, 180 programmers working every day. This is the schedule which are supposed to be achieved. The project manager enters that information at the end of the day. So much achieved, so much not achieved. So much achieved, so much not achieved. Okay. That information populates at URL. If you start looking at 180 people, how much they are achieved and how much they are not achieved, impossible.
Okay.
So what you do is that you take that schedule one access from them. Concept of PNP from you put that into your control chart and see that okay, my schedule one access varies between this and this line. The moment it hits upper level or lower level, there's something wrong with people there. Then just go and dig for that particular day, and find out that why this particular thing happened. One programmer did not come. Did not came, okay, he did not came. What was the risk planned for it, that person? Who was supposed to take, who was the resource on the bench who was supposed to take over? Why he couldn't take over? The reading was not given. So you factor a particular incident. And you can easily find out that incident from these particular graphs. If you set on, I don't want to take too much of time. If we sit together, probably I can define a lot of scenarios where actually it can be used. I just put in our time and cost to move.
So that's why I understand and appreciate. So basically what you're saying is helping with the decision making if a manager is also doing it on his own and instead of looking at the
outside. To be very shrewd, I would say it's not only make better decision making, I would say it's better to control on your team. Okay, because your subordinate can't say stupid manually. You know, that what's happened many time. Happens many time. We go either and we go and commit something. They look at each other, maybe they don't smile in front of us, but they bring our back, they are smiling. Okay? Because it's not possible for us to keep track of 20 projects every day, every group, which member is doing what. Okay? But then how do we identify these things? We can really identify these things from these charts. And it helps us. Now, if we don't go every day, but if we go on particular day and say that, was 3 days back the delivery thing you did, why did it took them so much of time? Where was that person? If he was not coming, what was your risk management plan was doing? Why you couldn't identify the risk are real? So you can directly point to a project manager and give this kind of role that this guy knows everything, how things are moving. Without understanding the setup.
Without control.
I gave an example at the time of my interview. When a person asked me, hey, what he was actually a very experienced person out of my age of 50 or 55. I gave him this call from ATL delivery. He asked me what ATL has given, because we have worked on IT organizations for many years, and even before ATL we were working, right? And we were working efficiently. So what ITL has given to IT industry, especially, they say, you might have driven the car on US roads, okay. You are driving there also. When you drive on Indian roads, what difference do you feel? You are driving at both the places, right? But where you feel comfortable? Obviously, US, right? You are doing the same thing. But you have everything disciplined. There are certain rules that you follow. And because of that, you are comfortable. Your driving speed is high, there is a low risk of accidents and all. Same thing, but if it is done in a disciplined manner, certain set of rules, then obviously your work or whatever you do, that will be efficient. So, best practice is nothing but the best way to do. You could be doing the same thing, but best practice will help you to know how I can do it best. Right? For example, IKEA has given the framework. For example, case management. We have case management tools ticket management tools. You can do it in Excel also, right? Many industries are doing that. But how efficient they are? They cannot take the proper reports out of it. They cannot do the proper analysis of data, and whereas you have the practices like incident management, problem management, change management, all these things have given you the certain framework how the relationship should be between the processes, and from that you can do the statistical analysis and come to some decisions. Whereas if you do it manually in some Excels and all, it would be very difficult. So ITIL has given certain framework by which you can have the relationships of different processes, and then you can come up with a system which can be giving you the best results in terms of revenue or efficiency. So definitely best practices are going to help us, not just common sense.
Is it all? All right.
Thank you.